Hey everyone. Today I want to show you one of those rare products that works so good and is so simple that it's actually hard to demonstrate. A lot of times you are doing virtual production, but one of the people that you want to put in your production is not in the same place as you are. They could be across town or across the world. You need to get the video from their camera to where you are. And you want to send the video live in real time, and you may want to send it from several people in several different places at once, all to yourself. You would think in this day and age of internet speeds and so on that this would be easy, but getting really solid broadcast quality video without a lot of work is actually tricky. I've tried out several different products that do this, and this one I'm about to show you seems to be the best to me. It's the easiest to set up and the most trouble-free I've tried. It also integrates really well with Unreal. It uses NDI to do this, so you can bring your videos into one computer in your studio and send them over Ethernet cables directly into Unreal. You can also take output from Unreal directly through NDI and send it out to somewhere else through the same software. Now let me show you the software. It's called Video Transport, and the first thing that's nice about it is that the company that built it, MediaLux, made it so you don't need to actually install it. You just download it and unzip it, and you get this folder. And you're pretty much ready to go at this point. This makes it so quick to install that you can literally have several different sites that are going to send you video, all set up and running from dead scratch in about 2 or 3 minutes. It's also very simple to use. When you want to publish a video for some other site to see, you just start this VT Publisher program. It opens up. And in a few seconds, you'll see all of the different video sources available on your machine. This includes all of your monitors. To publish one of these cameras, I just click on it. So I'll try my first camera here. And you see a preview comes up down below. When you're ready to start sending it, you just hit the Start Publishing button over here. Before you do that, you might want to select what bitrate you'd like to use, and you've got anywhere up to 80 megabits per second if your internet can handle it. Right now I'm going to leave it set at 10 because that's all I need for this format of video. Now any location that wants to receive video from you, all I have to do is start VT Receiver. And this is the program that manages receiving video. Now I'll just publish the video from my camera. And you see it pops up over here on the receiver. To get a preview of that, I can just click on it. And you can see now the video is being received over here as well. And it's reporting a latency that's fairly low, obviously, because it's just going in through my house right now. Then if I want to take this video and publish it on my machine so that it shows up as an NDI source, which you could use with Unreal or any other video production software, you just say Start Output. And now this is going to be showing up on my home network as an NDI video source. So the great thing about this is that it works exactly the way you just saw it work, even if the sender and the receiver are halfway around the world from each other. And trust me, I've tried this. I've run some videos between San Francisco and Stockholm, Sweden, Lebanon, and Paris. They all go from here to there very quickly and with no drama. The latency in all cases has been under a second, usually under a half a second, depending on how good your internet connection is. And generally, you don't see any errors or any degradation in the video at all. This uses a protocol called Secure Reliable Transport with some forward error correction layered on top. Basically what that means is your video is going to get there without errors or glitches in pretty much the same quality that you sent it every time without dropouts. It's also encrypted, so your video is going totally privately and can only be seen by people who have the same publisher ID set in the software as you do. As long as the bitrate on your connection is high enough, the video on the other end is going to look exactly the same as what you sent. You can use H.264 or H.265 encoding at as high a bitrate as you can stand. I run it up to 30 megabits per second with 4K video, and when the video arrives at the other end, it's totally clean and free of any artifacts and can be chroma keyed easily. To use the video you're receiving in Unreal, you can just follow my tutorial from a while back showing how to connect up NDI sources to Unreal. And that video will show up in Unreal just as a standard NDI camera. You'll be able to chroma key it and do your virtual production work with it. You can also easily use this to send your Unreal output across the world to someone else in real time. I'll show you one way to do that here. This software actually can send your monitor as if it was a camera. So I'll just click on my second screen where I happen to have Unreal running, and you can see it's going here now. And if I publish that, it shows up over here on my receiver, and if there were other receivers elsewhere in the world, it would show up on theirs too. And of course you can click that and get a preview of it. And if I wanted to send this full screen, I can just come over to my Unreal screen here and hit F11, and it goes full screen. You could also set up Unreal so that it sends the screen as an NDI output. You could also set up Unreal to generate an NDI output and have this program pick it up separately. That way you could have the screen show up with any resolution that you like for Unreal. Here's an example of some video that was sent to me in San Francisco from Beirut, Lebanon. You can see it's very sharp and high quality with no artifacts. Here's another piece of video that was sent from me in San Francisco to Paris, France. This was recorded on the Paris end and then sent back to me. Again, you can see the video is very clean, and there's no hint of artifacting in the blowing leaves or the moving truck. Another useful feature of the software is that you can run remote systems entirely by remote control. Start up the software on each computer, and then control it from a web panel, which you're looking at right now. The web panel shows you previews of all your sources. It allows you to set bit rates, change where the streams are going to and from. It's a lot like a traditional routing switcher. I think you'll find this software is useful for a lot of different things. Besides just bringing distant cameras into Unreal at your location, you can also send Unreal output anywhere you like. So if somebody needs to view the shoot that you're doing in virtual production in real time, you could use it to send the video to them. It's also very handy for doing things like interview shows or any time that you want to have multiple video streams put together. It works equally well with other software too, like Vmix or Wirecast or Xsymmetry. Anything that can support NDI will work well with this. Although I didn't demonstrate it here, it also sends multi-channel sound. So I hope you find this software useful. It's not free, but it is relatively inexpensive on a subscription basis. Again, you can get a free demo at the MediaLux website. The software is called Video Transport, and you'll find a link to their site in the description of this video. I hope this was helpful to you. See you next time.